Fine. So would just like to inform all the participants who have joined in that the meeting has also started streaming live onto YouTube. So for any of your members who wish to join it, it's the entire thing is available on YouTube as well with a link of puberty menorrhagia for Neha. Okay. You go on, Dr. Neha. Go on.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Today's subject is starting with everything regarding puberty and menorrhagia. Before we start our session, I would like to invite all the dignitaries for enlightening ceremony of Dhanvantri Pujan to kindly play Dhanvantri Stavan for grace.
Yeah. You want me to play that, right?
Okay.
Everyone else just stay unmuted, all right? I'll be just playing that. So I have two of them and I have been asked to play any one. So, okay, I'm just playing the first one. Yes, I hope it's audible.
Yes, sir, audible.
नमामि धन्वन्तरिं आदिदेवं सुरासुरैर्वन्दित पादपङ्कजं लोके जरार भयमृत्युनाशनम् दातारमीशं विविधौषधीना शङ्खं चक्रं जलौकां दधदममृतघटं चारुदोभिश्चतुर्भिः सूक्ष्मस् स्वच्छातिर्द्यांशुकपरिविलसन् मौलिमं भोजनेत्रं कालाम्भोदोज्वलाङ्गं कटितटविलसत् चारुपीताम्बराढ्यं वन्दे धन्वन्तरिन्तम् निखिलगदवन प्रौढदावागि नीलम् वन्दे धन्वन्तरिं वन्दे धन्वन्तरिं वन्दे धन्वन्तरिं
Right. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. After Dhanvantri Istivan, by the grace of God, now we start. And I would like to invite Dr. Sadhana Kulkarni, ma'am, President of NEMA Women Forum Central Council, for welcome speech. Please, Sadhana Kulkarni, ma'am.
So I think madam is not available because she is traveling somewhere. And I have a video from her, and I think we can probably play the video, but I do not know how good the effect of the video is going to be because it's a video received on WhatsApp. So I will just try and play it still, okay?
Okay, sir.
Probably, I don't know if it's going to be heard, but let's see.
Namaskar. Respected President NEMA Central, Dr. Tempurunikar, sir. Respected Secretary NEMA Central, Dr. U.S. Pandey, respected treasurer, NEMA Central, Dr. Kulkarni, sir. Today's eminent speaker, Dr. Jay Mehta, my secretary, Dr. Masud, my entire Women's Forum. Forum team, the technical guides of this webinar, Dr. Manish Joshi, Dr. Girish Daga, all the office bearers of NEMA Center and state, and all the delegates from all over India and all from a warm and grand welcome to all of you for this national webinar from Women's Forum Center. Due to some important family matter, I am out of station in a remote area. I am not sure about the net connectivity, so I have sent this video for this inaugural session. It is extremely proud moment for me to communicate with you as a president Women's Forum Central. After a major setback of COVID-19, today we have a great comeback with this national webinar of OPD level gynecology. The theme of this webinar is very unique, that is MM, that is from menarche to menopause. As a lady doctor, we always come across with various problems of M2M, that is from menarche to menopause in our daily OPD.
Thank you, Shadna Kulkarni ma'am, for this blessing.
Abhi pura nahi hua na?
Nahi, wo video cut ho gaya utne mein.
Due to some net connectivity issues.
Yeah, I think there is an internet connectivity even there, because all she could send was only this much, you know.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, ma'am, for blessings and kind words about me, ma'am. Now, for inauguration session of webinar, I would like to invite Dr. U.S. Pandey, sir, Secretary, NEMA Central Council, to influence us with some words.
Yeah, he's unmuted.
Dr. U.S. Pandey, sir, kindly influence us with some words.
Dhanyavad, Dr. Sir.
Can you hear, sir?
Yes.
Dhanyavad, Dr. Neha ji.
The most welcome.
इस कार्यक्रम के मुख्य अतिथि माननीय डॉक्टर विनायक जी तेंबुर्निकर, श्रद्धेय डॉक्टर आशुतोष कुलकर्णी जी, कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित समस्त गणमान्य चिकित्सक एवं इस महत्वपूर्ण सीएमई सतत चिकित्सा शिक्षा श्रृंखला कार्यक्रम के आयोजक डॉक्टर साधना कुलकर्णी जी, डॉक्टर मसोदकर जी, डॉक्टर कल्पना सिंह जी, डॉक्टर वंदना पाठक जी एवं नीमा वोमेन्स फोरम के अन्य पदाधिकारी गण, सदस्य गण, मैं इस सफल और उत्कृष्ट कार्यक्रम में आप सबका स्वागत और अभिनंदन करता हूं। बंधुओं, हम लोग अपने संगठन के माध्यम से स्थानीय एवं जिला स्तर पर स्वास्थ्य एवं चिकित्सा से संबंधित कुछ विशेष मेडिकल एजुकेशन प्रोग्राम चिकित्सा सेवा शिविर आयोजित करते आ रहे हैं। इस कार्यक्रम की सबसे महत्वपूर्ण विशेषता यह है कि इस तरह के एजुकेशनल वेबिनार का आयोजन राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर हो रहा है। इसके लिए हम नीमा राष्ट्रीय महिला फोरम के उत्कृष्ट कार्यों एवं उत्साह की सराहना करते हैं। साथ ही कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित समस्त चिकित्सक गण का स्वागत करते हुए इस कार्यक्रम को सफल बनाने के लिए धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करते हैं। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर योर काइंड वर्ड्स फॉर नीमा सेंट्रल वुमेन फोरम। नेक्स्ट, नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट अवर चेयरमैन डॉक्टर विनायक तेंबुर्निकर सर, प्रेसिडेंट नीमा सेंट्रल काउंसिल, टू स्पीच ऑफ प्रोग्राम।
डॉक्टर तेंबुर्निकर, यू आर अनम्यूटेड।
डॉक्टर विनायक तेंबुर्निकर सर,
थैंक यू नेहा जी।
Thank you. Basically,
I would like to thank initially Dr. Jay for his for the giving the permission and granting this web series for NEMA's Women Forum. Today, chief guest, chief speaker rather, or well-known or international fame speaker, my friend Dr. Jay, and all the team, Dr. Sadhana ji, Dr. Ashutosh ji, Dr. U.S. Pandey sir, Dr. Masodkar madam, and all the team, Neha ji, Priyanka ji. I wish all the best or very success to this webinar. Basically, Women's Forum ki sthapna isiliye hui thi ki we want to give a platform to the women here. We want to give platform to the leadership of the women, to the power of the women. And for that, Women's Forum was established in NEEMA. Aur aaj itne khushi mujhe hoti hai ki NEEMA Women's Forum has started working in many states. और जिन भी स्टेट्स में वो काम कर रहे हैं वो बहुत अच्छी तरह से बहुत ताकत से और बहुत लगन से बहुत मेहनत से काम कर रहे हैं. उसी का नतीजा ये है कि आज ये नेशनल वेबिनार हो रहा है और दैट टू विद डॉक्टर जय मेहता. जय मेहता की पॉपुलैरिटी तो आप सभी ने देखी है. जो जो नीमा से जुड़ा हुआ है वो सब लोग जय मेहता का नॉलेज उसकी उनकी पॉपुलैरिटी और उनके काम से वाकिफ है बहुत पूरी तरह से. सो एक अच्छी शुरुआत वुमेन्स फोरम सेंट्रल के वेबिनार के माध्यम से पोस्ट कोविड ईरा में हो रही है उसके लिए मैं वुमेन्स फोरम को धन्यवाद भी देता हूँ और उनके कार्य की सराहना भी करता हूँ. दूसरी बात ऐसी कि वुमेन्स फोरम का आज के लिए एक अच्छा खास दिन है इसलिए कि आज वुमेन्स फोरम ऑल दी प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे काम कर रही है. आज का अगर आप देखेंगे तो आज सोलापुर में मैं हूँ. सोलापुर में महाराष्ट्र वुमेन्स फोरम के स्टेट लेवल क्रिकेट टूर्नामेंट हो रही है और उसका फाइनल मैच अभी चल रहा है. आई एम देयर ऑन द ग्राउंड ओनली. दूसरी बात ऐसे कि ये वेबिनार की शुरुआत आज हो रही है जिससे मोर देन 5000 पीपल हैव बीन रजिस्टर्ड फॉर दिस वेबिनार. और तीसरी बात यह है कि आज शाम को एक महाराष्ट्र लेवल पे एक एंटरटेनमेंट प्रोग्राम होने जा रहा है जहां वुमेन्स का सिंगिंग कॉम्पिटिशन होने जा रहा है. तो आज के इसमें स्पोर्ट्स भी कवर कर रहे हैं हम, अकेडेमिक भी कवर कर रहे हैं और एंटरटेनमेंट भी कवर कर रहे हैं. दिस इज द वर्क ऑफ नीमा वुमेन्स फोरम एंड आई विश अ ग्रैंड सक्सेस टू
Dr. Timburnikar, you got muted. Please unmute yourself. You just clicked. Yeah. Now, Dr. Timburnikar, please unmute yourself. You've actually muted yourself by mistake. Wait, I've given you permission to be unmuted.
Okay. एक दूसरा फोन आ गया तो गलती से बटन दब गया. तो आई विश ग्रैंड सक्सेस टू द वेबिनार. वो जनवरी तक चलेगा और आई विश जय मेहता सर की और हमारी एसोसिएशन ऐसे ही सालों साल चलती रहेगी और जय मेहता जी का जो नॉलेज है वो हमारे सब जो लेडी डॉक्टर्स या गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट जो भी गायनिक में काम करते हैं उनके काम आ जाएगा इंक्लूडिंग द जनरल प्रैक्टिस. सो इतने शब्दों के इतने इसके साथ में अपने शब्दों को विराम देना चाहूंगा और विल प्रोसीड विद द लेक्चर ऑफ डॉक्टर जय मेहता जिसके लिए आप बहुत बेताब है सुनने के लिए डॉक्टर जय को. ओवर टू डॉक्टर जय.
थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर ब्लेसिंग्स एंड काइंड वर्ड्स एंड फाइनली इट्स टाइम टू स्टार्ट आवर साइंटिफिक सेशन. सो आई रिक्वेस्टेड टू माय को-होस्ट एंड एंकर डॉक्टर प्रियंका मैम टू कंटिन्यू द सेशन.
Thank you so much. Hello everyone, myself Dr. Priyanka from Bhandara. Welcome you all for much awaited event which is not only going to bring a confidence in your day-to-day gynec practice, but really will make a difference in your practical approach towards the gynec treatment at our OPD level. From menarche to menopause are just not the phases in the woman's life cycle, but it's a journey of hormonal synchrony, physiological changes, periodical changes in her life. So today's session is regarding everything about the puberty and puberty menorrhagia. This is a very important topic, enlightening on the heavy bleeding or the dysfunctional uterine bleeding in special category of adolescents or the young girls. We are now at we all know that the age of the menarche in the present modern society has decreased around 8 to 13 years. And this problem of heavy bleeding in her initial years of periods may last up to the 19 years of the age. So this is the category we are addressing today. Statistically, this problem is common, around 10 to 20%. More in rural area where we found anemia, malnutrition, tuberculosis, this is commonly seen in that area. But nowadays in urban area, due to the lifestyle, modern lifestyle changes, so we found in urban area also, it is very important to realize the girls may underestimate the amount of the blood loss or the subtle signs they have in that period. And in such situation, how to counsel the parents, how to categorize such patients and how to manage them at our GP level, because this puberty menorrhagia is a cause of a big time concern to that girl and their parents too. So let's have a talk on this by our renowned dynamic young gynecologist, Dr. Jay Mehta from Mumbai. His name is enough for introduction, I think so. And director and the founder of Shri IVF Clinic and the founder of Pran Endoscopy as well, completed his MBBS from KIM Hospital, Mumbai, and DNBA from Jubilee Mission Hospital, Thrissur. One who has a keen interest in minimal invasive and infertility. His smashed Facebook Live program, Live Laparoscopic Surgery program, have made a landmark for the educational platform for budding gynecs, like many of us. And he is the leading one, just not because he has a great skill, but has the ability to develop such confidence for that skill in the other newcomers gynec also. Truly a master, truly a very good mentor. Awarded by the best young gynecologist in Thrissur in 2014 and second best young gynecologist in Kerala state in 2013. Done fellowship in the robotic surgery and advanced assisted reproduction and embryology also. It is my honor to welcome Dr. Jay Mehta among us today. I was probably, or you too, brought up to believe that with such a highly popular personality, successful and passionate and distinguished with well-renowned gynecologist, one must be around 50, you know, 50 years or above that, and are commonly believed as a female gynec. But he has broken both the beliefs for many of us. A good-looking young gynecologist with his own YouTube platform, having lots of followers on Insta and Facebook, breaking so many records one by one. So this well-renowned person is well-received and respected, I might say, revered amongst his patients, where he helped them achieve a gift of their motherhood and sheer joy of being parents from patients. So I'm very proud to welcome such personality to educate us on the puberty and puberty menorrhagia. Now, let me introduce our another great famous personality, well-known gynecologist, chairperson for today's session, Dr. Vishnu Bhavane sir. Professor and HOD, Department of Srirog Prasuti in B.R. Harne Ayurvedic College, Thane. National Convener NEMA of Teachers Forum and former member of MCIM. He has received International Excellence Award at Malaysia for research in field of Ayurveda from Tathagat Ayurvedic Samsthan, Pune. Got Vaghbhat Award for the Excellence in Teaching on 2013, Las Vegas, USA. He had published book on management of asthenozoospermia with Ayurveda in Germany in 2011. Another book on
I think there is some issue as far as Priyanka's voice is concerned, you know. Priyanka, I think there is some voice issue which you are facing. Most probably. So I would just request someone else to, Dr. Neha, can you just stay online and stay unmuted? Is that okay with you?
Yes, sir. Definitely. So
we are losing now Priyanka's
time
voice
to start our scientific session. So I would request to our guest of speaker, Dr. Jay Mehta, sir, kindly. Just a minute. Dr. Sadhana Kulkarni, ma'am, can we hear? Hello.
Okay. If she's joined in, her video is stopped. Her network is not there.
Just for a few minutes, Dr. Sadhana Kulkarni, ma'am, are interested to say something. Hmm. So please, it's requested to Dr. Sadhana Kulkarni, ma'am.
Hello, everyone. I'm very sorry that I was not able to connect this program, inauguration program. I want to speak a few words with you. Welcome to all delegates from all over India. And welcome to our eminent speaker, Dr. Jay Mehta. As lady doctors, we always come across with various problems of menarche to menopause in our daily OPD. In spite of having expertise in gynec practice, updating ourselves is very essential. To update all these gynec practitioners from all over India on single platform of Women's Forum was our dream project. Today, this dream has changed into reality. I'm sure that the updates of recent trends in gynec practice, advanced technique will be very helpful for our delegates. Our eminent speaker, Dr. Jay Mehta, the Jay Mehta, I don't think that he needs any introduction. He is world famous IVF specialist. He is founder of mobile endoscopy unit. He has mastery in embryology and andrology. Apart from Dr. Mehta's super duper excellence in gynec and obstetric practice, I am always impressed by his teaching attitude and teaching technique. Maybe because I am also a teacher. He never delivers a typical type of lecture. He teaches the topic by interactive method, clears all the doubts, solves each and every even simple and stupid query. I salute to the teacher in Jay Mehta. This webinar will be helpful to our delegates to face new challenges in gynec practice. And this is the main aim of our project. But my friends, this is not only the aim of this seminar. There are also more objectives. Mainly, first is to build a strong network of women's forum throughout the country. Second is to motivate all other branches to conduct such activities. And thirdly, to add new members to NEMA and women's forum. And I'm sure that this webinar will be helpful in achieving our aims and objectives. Lastly, I'm very grateful to Central NEMA PST for their constant support and encouragement. I'm thankful to our technical team. Without their help, it was impossible to organize this webinar. I am very much thankful to Dr. Jay Mehta in advance that we are very lucky to have such a eminent speaker. At last, a grand salute to my Women's Forum team. Anything can be possible with such a dedicated teamwork. I hope the same cooperation in future. I appeal to all delegates to make this webinar successful, and thanks for listening my words. Thank you, Priyanka. Thank you, Masodkar, for giving me chance to share my few words. Thank you again.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for blessings and motivating words for us. And now the time, all the participants are eagerly waiting to hear Dr. Jay Mehta, sir. So I would like request to Dr. Jay Mehta, sir, please kindly start the scientific session now.
Yeah, Dr. Neha, just stay unmuted through the session. That's my only request, because I might be doing screen sharing. So what will happen is that I need somebody as a backup, and Priyanka's voice is not very clear. So guys, this is a session which we are going to be doing predominantly discussing puberty, right? There are two or three very, very important things which as family physicians, you need to understand, when we try and speak about puberty, okay? Very, very important things. So these are predominantly what exactly is puberty. That is what one thing which you need to understand. Second, you need to 100% follow it very categorically that when we are discussing pubertal problems at family physicians level, it is very, very important that you have a basic understanding of when to understand that lady is in problem. Okay, that is the first thing about puberty. Second, of course, we will be discussing the other issues of puberty, which is going to be predominantly menorrhagia, which is something which a lot of people see in their OPD practice. Okay. So now we'll request everyone to not post any messages in the chat box. Please don't post any messages in the chat box. I request one of you, Dr. Neha, I'm just requesting you to be please unmuted. Okay. Through the session. Absolutely unmuted, because I am otherwise going to be doing screen sharing. So I'll not be able to see the screen at all. All right. So I'm just starting the screen sharing content out here. And let me just actually start off with the whiteboard. So I just want to ensure if I'm audible, I'm audible,
yes,
right,
sir.
Dr. Neha?
It's audible. It's audible.
And you can see the whiteboard, right? You can see the
yes,
whiteboard.
Sir.
Okay, fine. So what is very important for all of us to now understand? Okay. So let me just draw everything for you because that is how I like to do it. So I'm writing puberty out here. Okay, this is going to be our topic for today. Now, what is important? See, when somebody hits puberty, what basically happens? There is something called as a hormonal shift. Okay, when you hit puberty, you have something called as a hormonal shift. Now, how does this hormonal shift help you or affect you? What happens is there is something in the brain. Okay, we know this part. This is something called as the hypothalamus and pituitary. Okay, hypothalamus and pituitary. We all know that there is a hypothalamus and pituitary. Now, along with the hypothalamus and the pituitary, we have the ovary, right? Now, whenever somebody hits puberty, what happens is the hypothalamo, pituitary, ovarian axis, this is called as the HPO axis. Okay, now this axis suddenly becomes active. Okay, there are multiple reasons for that. There are multiple reasons why it becomes active. But as family physicians, you should understand that this is one of the most important endocrine change which a lady is going to undergo. Okay, this is the most important endocrine change which is going to happen inside a lady. All right. Now, what typically happens when somebody hits puberty? So whenever the hypothalamo-pituitary axis becomes active, suddenly the ovary becomes active. And what does the ovary start to do? The ovary starts to secrete follicles. You know, these follicles give out a hormone which all of you like, which is called estrogen. Okay, and when the follicle ruptures, it forms something called as a corpus luteum, which gives out another hormone which is called as progesterone. Okay, where do these people go and act? Predominantly, these people go and act onto the uterus. Okay, now once this system becomes active, and let's assume in that particular menstrual cycle, the lady does not become pregnant. In that situation, the corpus luteum which has formed, it will undergo degeneration. And when it undergoes degeneration, there will be a sudden drop in progesterone level, which will give rise to the most important thing. Okay, and that is menses. Okay, so why did I explain this to you? Because one of the most important events in puberty is beginning of menses. All the ladies, all the female GPs, all the mothers identify this as something called as menarche. Okay, menarche means when did your periods begin? Okay, this is very, very important to understand. Now, along with this, what happens is, see, there is this hormone estrogen, I told you, because the ovary becomes active, there is a hormone estrogen. And what does estrogen do? You know, estrogen is the hormone which is responsible for all the secondary sexual characters. That means if I draw the female body this way, estrogen is responsible for development of the breast. Estrogen is going to be mildly, okay, not completely, mildly responsible for development of axillary hair. Estrogen is responsible for development of a female voice. And estrogen is also responsible for development of pubic hair. Now, along with all these things, estrogen is responsible for the development of the uterus as well and all other skin changes. So the most important thing which we look, the development of breast, all right? The development of breast is something which is called as telarch, okay? And the development of pubic hair is called as pubarch, okay? All these are very simple terminologies. You need not get confused, okay? But you must remember that all these are driven by hormones, and all this begins to happen only because the HPO axis becomes active. The hypothalamo pituitary ovarian axis becomes active, which then secretes estrogen, which gives rise to the phenomenon of menses, which we label as menarche, development of breast, which is called as telarch, and development of pubic hair and axillary hair called as pubarch. Of course, all the other changes, you know, the voice related changes, skin related changes, height, that means there is something called as a growth spurt, which is associated with this. Okay. So you would have seen that suddenly girls who are in sixth and seventh standard are small in height.
And these days, most of the girls hit menarche by the age of approximately 10 years to 12 years. Okay, that is when Indian girls hit menarche. So that means they begin to have menses, and suddenly by the time they are in 9th standard, they have a growth spurt. That means their height has grown up. They have breast development and they have a lot of signs of puberty. Apart from growth spurt and all these things, one more sign of puberty is called as something called as androgen buildup. And androgen buildup gives rise to something which is very, very common, and which is acne. Okay. Which is also a very common thing due to which mothers are going to visit you in your clinics. You know, meri beti ko ye ho gaya, meri beti ko wo ho gaya, this, that. 100 things a lady is going to come to you and tell you about. This is the absolute basic which everybody must know. There is absolutely nothing more important in puberty than understanding this concept. Remember, all problems of puberty can be treated just if you follow this single slide. If I label this as slide number one, if you follow it as slide number one, you will be able to by heart and treat each and every concept that is related to puberty, right? So for example, what is it that you should be worried about? Okay, we told that between 10 years and 12 years of age, right, people hit menarche. That means menses begin to appear. So then when should you be worried? You should be worried especially when girls do not have menses when they are age 13. This is the golden rule. Age 13 without menses and without secondary sexual characters. That means no breast development, no hair development, no axillary development. So that means secondary sexual characters are not developed. And at age 13, there is no menses. You should be worried. Otherwise, sometimes what can happen is breast development can occur before. Before, hair development can occur before, growth spurt can occur before, but menarche cannot come. All right. So that means when a lady has all secondary sexual characters, but no development of menses till age 15, right? That is when you should be worried. Very, very important. Again, very simple concept. Look, all this menses is related to estrogen and uterus. Very simple. Correct. So that means if a lady has not developed any of the characters, that means she has no axillary hair, no breast development, no pubic hair, okay, and no menses. That means most probably there is some problem in the estrogen. Very simple, no? She has not developed estrogen in the body. So this is to be categorized at age 13, which is called as primary amenorrhea. Understanding? Or what can happen is the lady has estrogen. So that means she had axillary hair development, she has breast development, she had pubic hair, she had growth spurt, she had acne, but she did not get into menses. Iska matlab, estrogen is going good, but locha problem is going to happen in the uterus. Okay, this is very, very, very common. Simple, one simple slide will explain this entire thing to you. Understood? So these are the two golden things you should remember. Age 13 without secondary sexual characters. Age 15 with secondary sexual characters. That means in the presence of breast development. This is one thing which you must 100% remember as far as first problem of puberty is concerned, and that is absent menses, or something which we commonly label as primary amenorrhea. All right. So I will just erase off all the things which we don't need at the moment. Okay. I will just erase off all these things. Right. And we will discuss something about puberty menorrhagia, because that is one thing which family physicians must know. Okay. They must know this and they must by heart this. Remember, we treat close to 150 to 200. 100 women who do not have a uterus or do not have a vagina every year. Okay. And that is a very difficult treatment to do, because what happens is everybody is going to school, and when they go to school, they are expecting that uski beti ko period aaya to meri beti ko kyun nahi aaya. No. This is a very common problem which they have. Okay. Just 1 minute. So I would just request, is Neha, I would request you to be unmuted, yaar. Please stay unmuted. My voice is audible, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So one of the most common problems which we see is amenorrhea. What is amenorrhea? Amenorrhea means absent menses. Okay. Now from all what we learned, okay, as we know, the hypothalamo-pituitary-ovarian axis, once this ovarian axis becomes active, we have a very important hormone, which is estrogen. And where does this estrogen come from? The estrogen comes from the ovary. Okay, and where does it go and act? It goes and act on the uterus. And apart from uterus, it will go and cause breast development. It will cause axillary hair development. And it will cause pubic hair development. and it will also cause a growth spurt. All these things are going to happen due to estrogen. Very, very simple concept now we are understanding, okay? So the first thing is, kuch aisa ho gaya that ovary became malfunctional. That means there will be no estrogen. When ovary does not function, there is no estrogen. So that means there will be absent menses plus absent breast development, okay, plus short stature. Simple, short stature because there is no growth spurt. So there will be short stature. One of the most common conditions which family physicians must remember, especially when they see short stature. Apan bolte hai na, are tere bacche ka height bahut chota hai, right? When they see this, they must first try and think that if it is a lady, you must rule out lack of estrogen or a non-functional ovary. And the most common cause in India is something called as Turner syndrome. Okay, this is a genetic problem. This is the most common cause in India for this to happen. Turner syndrome is 45X0. Remember, normal female is 46XX. So that means one X chromosome is missing. And as a result of this, ovary is not functional, due to which there is no estrogen, due to which there is absent menses, absent breast and short stature. Now, Turner has lots of variations, but this at family physician level is important for you to understand. Okay, so what is the treatment of Turner syndrome? Very simple. You want growth and you want estrogen. So what do? You give growth hormone supplement, GH supplement plus estrogen supplement. Hai na? Simple. See, in one slide, you have become an endocrinologist. You will learn everything. If you do this, then you have to do this. Very simple. Now let's assume another problem. Okay, very common. Huh? All these problems are just related to just one slide. Just see this now. How it will happen. See, second most common cause of having this problems of primary amenorrhea in our country, in India. Okay, see, ovary is functional. First thing, ovary is completely functional. So what has happened? When the ovary becomes functional, what has happened to you? See, are, isko kya ho gaya? Okay, somebody is probably trying to print on my screen. So I request people to avoid doing that. So what is going to happen in that? See, when the ovary is functional, estrogen is active. So when estrogen is active, that means there will be breast development. There will be a growth spurt. There will be axillary hair and there will be pubic hair. But Bhagwan ne ek problem de diya that uterus is not present. Okay, apart from all these things, the uterus is absent. So then what will happen in that situation, despite having secondary sexual characters, means despite having good breast development, despite having a good height, despite having good secondary sexual characters, despite having a good female voice, okay, very nice female voice, despite having a good skin, uterus is only absent, or uterus is hypoplastic. Hypoplastic matlab normal se chota, okay. In that situation, the end organ means estrogen is being produced, but uterus is not functioning. So then also you can have absent menses, right? This is the most common thing which happens in our country, which is called as MRKH syndrome. Okay, MRKH syndrome is a condition where uterus is not functional, and along with the uterus not being functional, the vagina, okay, is not nicely visible. So that means the patient has absent menses plus absent vagina. This is very common. What is the treatment for this? Do you know? The treatment is very simple. You need to recreate the vagina. You need to do a surgery called as vaginal reconstruction. We have posted this surgery multiple times. Okay. You need to recreate this surgery. So recreate the vagina so that there is sexual activity. But the commonest thing which the patient asked is, "Pali yenar na doctor?" Means period aayega na patient ko. The answer to that question is no, because God has not given a uterus. So even if you recreate the vagina, it is only for sexual function. There will be no menses even after doing that. Understanding? These are the most commonest problems which a family physician faces in their practice. And now I'm going to tell you about the third problem, which is even more common. Okay, in today's generation, this is superb. Huh? This is the one of the most common problems which people see in today's generation. I'm sure if I keep the chat box open, 100 people will answer. I have seen it 100 times in my OPD. Okay, like that. 100 people will answer this. Okay. Let's assume a situation where ovary is normal. That means hypothalamic pituitary ovarian axis is normal. So estrogen is normal, ovary is normal, and uterus is also normal. Hai na? Uterus is normal. अब क्या प्रॉब्लम है. देन ऑल्सो देर इज नो मेंसेस, देन ऑल्सो देर इज ए मेनोरिया. बट यू नो वॉट इज द प्रॉब्लम, बच्चा है ना मैकडोनल्ड्स में जाके खाना बहुत खाता है, बच्चा है ना चिकन बहुत खाता है, बच्चा है ना एक्सरसाइज नहीं करता है, पढ़ाई पे ध्यान देता है. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज ओबीस पॉलीसिस्टिक ओवेरियन सिंड्रोम. दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉजेज इन अवर कंट्री टू हैव प्राइमरी एमेनोरिया, राइट. मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज. In fact, all these genetic causes are not so common. If you look at a broad spectrum, then one of the most common answers is when there is obesity, there is going to be some severe trouble as far as menstruation is concerned. Okay. And this is one thing which family physicians must rule out. In that situation, ovary will be normal, uterus will be normal, axis will be normal, estrogen is normal, everything is normal. But the problem is that the patient is obese. And in all these situations, there is one more culprit which you must remember, and which is thyroid. Okay, so hypothyroidism is something that means reduced high level of TSH, TSH excess, which is called as hypothyroidism, is something which is very, 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 very commonly related to these problems. And you must, as family physicians, remember just these 3 to 4 causes. If you remember these 3 to 4 causes in your practice, then your life is going to be extremely, extremely, extremely easy as far as treating amenorrhea of puberty is concerned. All right. With this, what we are going to do is that I'm going to stop the screen sharing. I'm going to come back to the routine screen. I really hope and I pray that what I just spoke for the last maybe 25 to 30 minutes has been very receptive and very easy. Right. If you have understood this as a concept, the puberty treatment for pediatric gynecology or adolescent gynecology is going to become a cakewalk for all of you, because this was the most important endocrine explanation which you would have had to listen in a situation like this. Once you follow this, once you follow the fact that HPO axis, that is hypothalamo pituitary ovarian axis, uterus, ovary and estrogen, once you follow this as a concept, treating any pubertal problem is going to become very, very easy. Now with this, we are going to move on to the next most common problem of puberty, which is puberty associated menstrual disorders. Okay, so this can be puberty menorrhagia, this can be irregular cycles in puberty, hundreds of things. Okay, in order to understand this, you should understand yourself. You know why you should understand yourself? Because this problem is just like how a doctor's practice is. When you begin your practice, let's assume, you know, 10 years before you began to do your practice. In your first year, you are going to have a lot of issues. Hai na? Patients nahi aayenge. Patients aayenge to patients ko lagega ke doctor bahut junior hai. Doctor bahut junior hai to doctor ke paas experience nahi hai. Doctor ke paas experience nahi hai to shayad dawai dene mein gadbad ho sakti hai. All these things are a vicious circle. Maan ke chalo, you gave medicine to some patient and patient ko complication ho gaya. तुम्हारा कॉन्फिडेंस गया उधर का उधर. अरे बापरे बापरे, आई गिव मेडिसिन, यू नो दवाई काम नहीं किया, आई एम सो स्केर्ड, ऑल दीज थिंग्स. साइमल्टेनियसली यू आर वरीड, मैंने ये दवाई दिया तो मेरा सीनियर क्या सोचेगा, मैंने ये दवाई दिया तो ये क्या सोचेगा. 100 कॉम्प्लिकेशंस यू हैव. नहीं, और जस्ट लाइक हाउ एन ओपनिंग बैट्समैन इज इन क्रिकेट, स्टार्टिंग का 2 ओवर वो एडजस्ट होने को जाता है, अरे बॉल स्विंग हो रहा है या नहीं, बॉल का पेस क्या है, विकेट का पेस क्या है, ये सब उसको समझना है, उसके बाद में वो शॉट खेलने का चालू करेगा. एग्जैक्टली द सेम थिंग हैपेंस इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी, एग्जैक्टली द सेम थिंग. आई जस्ट शो दैट टू यू इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ अ ब्यूटीफुल डायग्राम सो दैट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड. आई एम अगेन गोइंग टू बी शेयरिंग माई व्हाइट बोर्ड सो यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट वेरी नाइसली. सी, व्हेन द एचपीओ एक्सिस इज गेटिंग एक्टिव, मान के चलो वी जस्ट सेड दैट द हाइपोथैलेमो पिट्यूटरी ओवेरियन एक्सिस नॉर्मली, सो मेनार्क नॉर्मली अकर्स एट अप्रोक्सिमेटली 11 इयर्स. सो लेट्स अज्यूम 11 इयर्स पे ये एक्सिस एक्टिव हो गया. ओके, अब व्हेन दिस एक्सिस गेट्स एक्टिव, इट हैज टू मैनेज हु, इट हैज टू मैनेज द ओवरी एंड इट हैज टू मैनेज द यूट्रस. बराबर, वेरी वेरी सिंपल. सो लेट्स अज्यूम स्टार्टिंग के दिन है, हाइपोथैलेमस इज आस्किंग द ओवरी, अरे ओवरी ओवरी प्लीज तू यार जरा फॉलिकल बना अच्छे साइज का, बड़ा वाला है ना, तू बड़े साइज का फॉलिकल बना और देख एग्जैक्टली 30 डेज में बना के रखना ताकि रेगुलर साइकिल जाए ये लेडी को, है ना. What is regular cycles? Regular cycle means ladies having period and a fixed time, 30 days, 28 days, whatever. Starting hai career ka. So what did ovary say? Hut, main tera baat nahi manega. Main kyun tera baat manu starting mein? 15 saal tak tu kidhar tha? You know, in that jhagda between the hypothalamus, pituitary and the ovary says, main to cycle dunga har 45 days pe. मैं 30 डेज का साइकिल नहीं दूंगा, मैं 45 डेज पे ही साइकिल दूंगा, और वो भी मैं नवंबर में 45 डेज का दूंगा, दिसंबर में 60 डेज का दूंगा, जनवरी में मैं 30 डेज का साइकिल दूंगा, जा तेरे से जो होता है वो तू कर, बराबर। सो इन दैट टाइप ऑफ सिचुएशन व्हाट डज पुअर हाइपोथैलेमस से, पुअर हाइपोथैलेमस इज देन एक्टिंग लाइक अ मैरिड हस्बैंड, उसके पास में सुनने के अलावा और कोई चॉइस ही नहीं है, समझ में आया? तो हाइपोथैलेमस और पिट्यूटरी बेचारा सुनते रहता है, ठीक है भाई तेरे को जो मर्जी में आए वो तू कर, बराबर, मेरे को परेशान मत कर। सो दैट इज एग्जैक्टली हाउ द ओवरी बिहेव्स, एग्जैक्टली हाउ द ओवरी बिहेव्स, अंडरस्टैंडिंग। बट अब मान के चलो डॉक्टर का प्रैक्टिस एस्टैब्लिश हो गया, शादी का 2 साल हो गया, अभी हस्बैंड को आदत हो गया है वाइफ का, यू नो उसको मालूम ही है कि उसकी वाइफ उसको फोन करके बोलेगी कि मैं खाने में क्या बनाऊ, वो बोलेगा तुमको जो बनाने का बनाओ, और वाइफ उसको तो भी चिल्लाएगी कि तुमको कुछ सोचता नहीं है क्या अच्छा खाना बनाने के लिए, लाइक दैट After 1 to 2 years, 3 years, sometimes, you know, आजकल शादी में एडजस्ट होने को भी टाइम जाता है, तो आज के जमाने में पकड़ो 3 साल हो गया। सो बाई द एज ऑफ 14 to 15 years, what happens is, है ना, everybody is used to each other. Hypothalamus and pituitary को पता है कि ओवरी पागल है, ओवरी को पता है कि मैं कितना भी नाटक करूंगा hypothalamus मेरा सुनने नहीं वाला है, और अगर वो मेरा सुनने नहीं वाला है तो मैं थोड़ा नॉर्मल हो जाता हूँ, अंडरस्टैंडिंग। सो once you give hypothalamus pituitary axis some time, when you give it time, what happens is over time irregular cycles become regular cycles, understanding? This is the most important thing you should understand. So the first treatment when you have a female patient who has irregular cycles but is in this age group, you know, 11 12 and 13 years old, is that you should counsel them and you should tell them कुछ टेंशन मत लो, जस्ट वेट एंड वॉच, यू नो, रिमेंबर द पेशेंट हैज नो प्रॉब्लम, प्रॉब्लम इज गोइंग टू बी विद द पेशेंट्स मदर, अंडरस्टैंडिंग। पेशेंट की माँ को ऐसा लगता है कि मेरी देवरानी की बेटी को बराबर से पीरियड आता है तो मेरी बेटी को क्यों नहीं आ रहा है, मेरे मोहल्ले में सबकी बेटियों को पीरियड ठीक से आ रहा है तो मेरी बेटी को क्यों नहीं आ रहा है, वो बेचारी बेटी को तो कुछ टेंशन ही नहीं है ये सब चीज का, अंडरस्टैंडिंग। सो यू हैव टू काउंसिल द मदर एंड यू हैव टू टेल द मदर that all this is normal in this age group. In the early first 2 to 3 years of hypothalamic pituitary ovarian axis, it is normal for a lady to have irregular cycles. Agar irregular cycles hai, then don't worry about it, don't panic about it. Correct? Lot of times what happens is these irregular cycles are associated with heavy bleeding. That means if the period has come after 60 days, the lady is going to have another bleeding for 13 to 14 days. So in that type of situation, as family physicians, you should just do 2 things. One is CBC to look at the iron status of the lady or to look at the hemoglobin of the lady. And second is you should do a USG, ultrasound, okay? Just to ensure if the uterus is normal, okay? If these 2 things are normal, then all you need to give, if hemoglobin is low, is to give iron supplement. That's it, okay? Apart from iron supplementation, you should not give anything else in this age group, understanding, if there is heavy bleeding. But let's assume the lady is having irregular cycles continuously. That means wo tumhare paas mein 11 saal pe aayi, tumne bola tension mat lo, hai na, ye hota hai, naya naya shaadi hai, adjust hone ko time ho jayega. Wo tumhare paas 12 saal pe bhi aayi, tumne wapis yahi baat bata diya usko. अब जब वो अगर 13 साल पे, मतलब तीसरे साल पे आएगी, अरे डॉक्टर ब्लीडिंग बहुत हो रहा है कुछ करके दो, और अगर तुमने बोला कुछ मत करो तो या वो तुमको छोड़ के किसी दूसरे डॉक्टर के पास जाएगी, ये है फर्स्ट ऑप्शन, या दूसरा ऑप्शन कि वो तुमको एक झापट मारेगी, समझ में आया, कि तुमको समझ में नहीं आता है मेरी बेटी को इतना ब्लीडिंग होता है ना। इफ द ब्लीडिंग इज वेरी हैवी, देन इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द ब्लीडिंग यू कैन गिव एनी एजेंट विच हेल्प्स इन रिड्यूसिंग ब्लीडिंग, एंड द मोस्ट कॉमन is tranexamic acid, right? So a combination of tranexamic acid plus mefenamic acid, which is commonly available as Tranexa, okay, is commonly given. I have seen a lot of female family physicians who love to give ethambutol. Yeah, they love ethambutol. But remember, ethambutol cricket ke team ka 12th batsman hai, समझ में आया? यू कैनॉट एक्सपेक्ट योर सेल्फ टू विन अ मैच गिविंग इथम साइलेट. तो इथम साइलेट मत दो यार. अगर तुमको कुछ देना ही है ना तो ट्रैनेक्सामिक एसिड प्लस मेफेनामिक एसिड का कॉम्बिनेशन दो. ओके, दैट इज वे मोर सेफ, वे मोर इफेक्टिव. जस्ट दीज टू थिंग्स आर गोइंग टू रिड्यूस द ब्लीडिंग बाई 60-80%. ओके, एंड द पेशेंट इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी हैप्पी that the bleeding went down by 60-80%, hai na? So this is something which you should remember as family physicians. Now, what is the dose of the medication which you should be giving? Remember, tranexamic acid can be given in a maximum dose, especially in this young population, for up to 3 times in a day. Though up to 4 times in a day is okay, but the max dose you should give is tranexamic acid 3 times in a day, probably not more than that. Okay, and of course, you should counsel the patient for all the other things which you are going to do. You should be going to do a CBC, you should do an ultrasound, and if it is consistent, then you should also do a TSH and rule out if there is any hypothyroid problem in the lady. All right. So I hope this very simple logic of puberty menorrhagia is very clear to you. But apart from all these things, now I'm coming to something which is very important. Now let's assume, okay, these irregular cycles continue to be irregular. That means the lady has come to you at 11, 12, 13, 14 years, whatever. You have done all these miri masala things, sonography is normal, CBC normal, iron supplementation de diya. Tumne sab kuch kar diya. But she is still complaining ki nahi, mere ko regular cycle nahi aa raha hai bhai. Mera to cycle jo hai, doctor abhi mera already umar ho gaya hai 14 years. Or 14 years pe I am having cycles which are coming every 45 to 60 days. Barabar. Or period mein bhi problem hai. कंपल्सरी नहीं है कि पीरियड हैवी है. समटाइम्स पीरियड हैवी है, समटाइम्स पीरियड लाइट है. अगर तुमको किसी ने ऐसा बोला, देन द फर्स्ट थिंग विच यू शुड चेक इज द वेट. इफ इट इज ओबीस, द आंसर इज वेरी सिंपल, इट इज पीसीओएस. इफ द लेडी इज थिन, देन लुक एट द हेयर ग्रोथ. लुक एट द हेयर ग्रोथ. दीज डेज वुमन डोंट लाइक टू हैव एबनॉर्मल हेयर ग्रोथ ऑन द चिन, ऑन द चीक, ऑन द आर्म, ऑन द लिम्ब, ऑन द बैक. एंड दीज डेज गर्ल्स इवन इन सेकेंड टायर सिटीज are absolutely fond of doing laser treatment to removing the hair. Understanding, please rule out thin PCOS or obese PCOS in such women. And remember, one of the treatments of choice in all these people is to lose weight if they are obese. And if they are thin, then the treatment of choice is oral contraceptive pills for patients who are thin. For obese people, the simplest of the choices is to lose weight. Till you do not lose weight, you are not going to be able to have a good outcome in this disease. Otherwise, the lady is going to need a combination of oral contraceptive pills plus minus metformin. Okay, this is a very large topic in itself, polycystic ovarian syndrome. So I'm not going to go into huge details of polycystic ovarian syndrome at the current moment. But I think these basics of this entire treatment are something which all family physicians should virtually keep in their mind. Okay, now third most common problem. Abhi tak to apan kidhar the, atke hue the. I think Neha, she is the only person who is unmuted. Neha, abhi tak apan sirf ovary pe atke hue the, barabar na?
Ji sir.
Abhi apan ne ovary ko chhod diya. Ab maan ke chalo ovary normal hai, you know, ekdam sharif biwi ki tarah hai ovary, barabar? Ekdam aisa koi hota nahi hai, aisa life mein koi hai hi nahi wife jo acha rehta hai. पर मान के चलो कि ये वाला बहुत ही अच्छा है, बराबर. शादी होते ही सब रूल फॉलो करता है, जैसे हाइपोथैलेमस बोलता है वैसे फॉलिकल बनाता है, यू नो, सब कुछ यू नो, सब कुछ ठीक से करता है. ओवरी का हार्मोन सिक्रेशन भी बहुत अच्छा है. ओवरी इज सिक्रेटिंग एक्सीलेंट एस्ट्रोजन, ओवरी इज सिक्रेटिंग एक्सीलेंट प्रोजेस्टेरॉन, है ना, सब कुछ ठीक से हो रहा है. पर प्रॉब्लम कौन है पता है? कितना गंदा खाना तुमने बना दिया, यू नो, वो सासुमा का नाम है यूट्रस. जब सब कुछ ठीक चल रहा है घर में, तो एक ही आदमी ऐसा हो सकता है जो घर की हार्मनी डिस्टर्ब कर सकता है, एंड वो है सासुमा. और वो सासुमा का नाम है यूट्रस. समझ में आया? When hypothalamus is working beautifully, ovary is working beautifully, estrogen is perfect, progesterone is perfect, all of them go and have an end result. ये सब का end result होता है यूट्रस पे. अब अगर यूट्रस बिगड़ गया, यूट्रस ने बोला तुम्हारे से जो होता है करो, मैं तो मेरे हिसाब से ही चलूंगा, बराबर, मैं नॉर्मल एस्ट्रोजन लेवल पे भी ज्यादा ब्लीडिंग करूंगा, जाओ तुमको जो करना है करो, मैं पीरियड के पहले दूसरे या तीसरे दिन पे आते ही, क्योंकि मुझे तकलीफ हुई इसीलिए मैं बहुत स्पाजम में जाऊंगा, ऑन द फर्स्ट सेकेंड थर्ड डे ऑफ पीरियड आई विल स्पाजम एंड आई विल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, यू नो, जिसके वजह से वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन इश्यूज विच फैमिली फिजिशियंस फेस इज ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ पेन ड्यूरिंग पीरियड्स इन दिस यंग गर्ल्स, एस्पेशली इन द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 11 to 16 ईयर्स ओल्ड, है ना, वेरी कॉमन दैट गर्ल्स आर कंप्लेनिंग, अरे डॉक्टर पीरियड के पहले दिन पे बहुत पेन हो रहा है, व्हाई, बिकॉज यूट्रस हैज डिसाइडेड दैट डिस्पाइट हार्मोन्स बीइंग नॉर्मल आई एम गोइंग टू हैव स्पाज्म, स्पाज्म मतलब कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इन ऑर्डर टू थ्रो द ब्लड आउट, एंड स्पाज्मोडिक डिसमेनोरिया इज वेरी वेरी कॉमन, स्पाज्मोडिक डिसमेनोरिया इज समथिंग वेर देर इज स्पाज्मोडिक पेन इन द पीरियड, दिस इज टिपिकल ऑफ द फर्स्ट और द सेकेंड डे ऑफ द पीरियड्स, ओके। आजकल की लड़की लोग बहुत होशियार है, बाजू वाले को पेन होता है ना तो खुद के पर्स में उनके पास में टैबलेट रहता है, तुला पोटा दुखत का, तेरे को पेट में दर्द हो रहा है, मेरे पास में टैबलेट अवेलेबल है, यू नो, ये ले टैबलेट, एंड दैट टैबलेट विच दे ऑल कीप एंड दे लव टू कीप इज साइक्लोपाम, सब लोग के जेब में मिलेगा तुमको, यंग लेडीज लोग के। अब थोड़े इसमें से लेडीज लोग ऐसे रहते हैं जो डेढ़ छाने रहते हैं, यू नो, उनको पता है कि अगर ऐसा किया स्कूल में जाके कि पीरियड के दिन पे मेरे को बहुत पेन है तो टीचर कुछ बोलेगा नहीं, होमवर्क में से छुट्टी मिल जाएगा, घर पे जल्दी आने को मिलेगा, घर पे आके टीवी देखने को मिलेगा, मम्मी को पापा को टेंशन आ जाएगा कि अरे मुझे तो बहुत पेन हो रहा है, डॉक्टर के पास पकड़ के लेके जाओ, डॉक्टर बोलेगा अरे बिचारी बिचारी बहुत पेन हो रहा है क्या करेंगे, यू नो, प्लीज रिमेम्बर इन स्पाज्मोडिक डिसमेनोरिया यूट्रस इज गोइंग टू बी नॉर्मल ऑन अल्ट्रासाउंड, सो दैट इज समथिंग विच यू मस्ट डू, इफ द अल्ट्रासाउंड ऑफ द यूट्रस इज नॉर्मल the lady has spasmodic dysmenorrhea and the treatment is to give cyclopam tablets probably 2 or 3 times in a day, any other antispasmodics is good, okay, it is not compulsory that you should give cyclopam only, you can give drotin, you can give buscopan, you can give hyosimax, you can give whatever you want, everything has a good effect on spasms, understanding, ab agar tumne ye pakad liya then mother will be very happy, father will be very happy, teacher will be very happy, but patient will be very unhappy, क्योंकि तुमने उसका पूरे प्लान पे चौपट कर दिया, यू नो, उसने पूरा प्लान करके रखा होता है कि ये दिन पे एग्जाम है, एग्जाम के दिन पे मैं बोलूंगी पोटात खूब दुखते, मेरे को कोई एग्जाम में जाने नहीं देगा और मैं बच जाऊंगी, पर यहाँ पे डॉक्टर बहुत होशियार हो गए हैं, अभी डॉक्टर ने बोला कि नहीं सोनोग्राफी नॉर्मल है तो साइक्लोपाम दे दो, साइक्लोपाम देने से ठीक हो जाएगा, अंडरस्टैंडिंग, दिस इज द अदर गोल्डन थिंग यू शुड रिमेम्बर, बिकॉज स्पाज्मोडिक डिसमेनोरिया इज एक्सट्रीमली कॉमन इन यंग गर्ल्स, ऑलराइट, नाउ अलोंग विद दैट समटाइम्स मान के चलो सासू माँ को बहुत ज्यादा गुस्सा आ गया, यू नो, तो क्या करती है, इन लोगों को जाना है पिक्चर देखने के लिए, इस्ट्रोजन और प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन को, नया पिक्चर आया है सूर्यवंशी, इस्ट्रोजन और प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन ने डिसाइड किया कि हम पिक्चर देखने जाते हैं, पर सासू माँ को आ गया गुस्सा कि नहीं इसने मेरी नड़न के साथ में ठीक से बात नहीं की है ये, तो मैं उसको अभी ट्रबल करूंगी, सो वॉट डज दैट यूट्रस डू, डिस्पाइट एवरीथिंग बीइंग नॉर्मल इट इंक्रीजेस द ब्लीडिंग, है ना, सासू माँ अननेसेसरली बिगड़ गई, अब जब ब्लीडिंग ज्यादा होने लग जाता है दैट एट दैट टाइम एवरीबॉडी इज इन प्रॉब्लम, अरे उसको ना पेट में दर्द हो रहा है, ओवरी नॉर्मल है, अल्ट्रासाउंड भी नॉर्मल है, प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन नॉर्मल है, इस्ट्रोजन नॉर्मल है, हाइपोथैलेमस नॉर्मल है, सब कुछ नॉर्मल है, तो किस चीज के वजह से हैवी ब्लीडिंग हो रहा है, रिमेंबर वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन रीजंस टू to have heavy bleeding is going to be something called as endometrial factors, okay, in these young girls. Matlab, it is a cause which is localized cause, hyper anxiety, hyper progesterone, all these causes which you can localize to the uterus, ye sare karan ke wajah se, these girls can have heavy bleeding. And the treatment is again very simple, you should not give ethambutol, you should give a combination of tranexamic acid plus mefenamic acid, okay. And if you think that this combination is also not helping you, then the second treatment of choice is to give OCPs. Okay. But in again, whenever somebody has heavy bleeding, as family physicians, one of the first things which you should rule out is hemoglobin. How low is the lady's hemoglobin? And based on her hemoglobin, you should decide how aggressive should your treatment be as far as this particular lady is concerned. You know? So with this much information, what I think is I'm going to finish quite a lot of basic topics as far as puberty and pubertal menorrhagia is concerned. You know, this should only be a concept. You should not try to by heart all these things. This is a concept. If you understand the concept nicely, this concept is going to be the same even after 50 years. This concept is not going to change. Maybe there is going to be some medication which is going to change up and down, but the concept is going to be the same. So I hope in the last 45 minutes or maybe probably 50 minutes of what I have spoken, I have been able to explain this entire concept to you. If there is something which you want me to discuss more and add, then I'll be happy to add. So Priyanka, I don't know if she's still there. Priyanka, I have asked you to unmute, and Priyanka, actually we can't see you though, but if you can on your video, it'll be nice.
Yeah, video is on. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, but yes, your sound is cracking.
Okay, right now? Right now?
I can hear you, but I can't see you. I can't see you.
My video is on.
Okay, no problem. So is there anything else, Priyanka, which you want me to discuss regarding puberty?
Yes, I want to know when this, you know, how to estimate that blood loss to, you know, to categorize these patients, you know, with means if you want to treat them on the OPD level.
Yeah. See, remember one thing. One of the most simplest history when you want to categorize the amount of bleeding which you should ask your patient is that, is she passing clot or is she not passing clot? That is the most important thing which you should be asking. Okay. Now, if a lady is passing clots, you must practically assume that she is in having severe menorrhagia. All right. That is a very important thing. Okay. Second, you must ask how much is the frequency of changing her pads. So if somebody tells you that she is changing 20 pads in a day, obviously she is with menorrhagia, because the normal physiological ratio at which somebody can change pads is going to be between 3 to 4. Okay. In these young girls, you can make it 2 to 4. It's okay for a young girl to shed just 2 pads of blood every day. All right. Or probably just for the first day, and then half of that on the second day, and then half of that on the third day. And then the bleeding usually stops in these young girls, unless they are very obese. Okay. But estimation of clots is something important, and the number of pads through which they are bleeding. These are, you know, very impractical estimates. The other estimates which you are going to get is on your clinical examination. Iron studies, you know, not just hemoglobin, but iron studies. What is serum ferritin? That is something which you should check if you have the facility available. Because serum ferritin is a baseline investigation which you should be doing in all young girls with pubertal menorrhagia. All young girls, you must do it.
Yes. And, you know, after correction of this acute menstrual bleeding at our level, what kind of a maintenance hormonal therapy we should include in that? Means the type of progesterone or estrogen, what we should prefer in that case?
So for the first 2 episodes, there should be nothing. Like, okay, let's assume somebody had an episode in January, then don't do anything. Don't give any maintenance, because the cycle, the axis is yet to get balanced, you know, as I told you. It is an age-related thing. So as the age increases, the axis will automatically balance out itself. So that is one thing which you should be, you know, trying to understand. That first episode and second episode, you should not do anything. If at all there is something which is happening from the third episode onwards, then, as I said, most probably the cause is endometrial. And because it is an endometrial cause, the patient should be put on at least 6 to 9 cycles of low-dose oral contraceptive pills.
Okay. And if when we come to know that the adolescence is having some bleeding disorders, then how to manage such patients?
Most important, see, in today's times, what you should understand is that when you have bleeding disorders in adolescents, which is, one, it is not very common, right? It is predominantly due to either some platelet-related issues or some clotting factor-related issues or whatever it is. Okay. Usually you are going to pick it up even before menarche. Okay. In today's world, the testing is so good that somebody is playing cricket or not cricket. Let's assume somebody is playing in the school and they fell down and they had too much bleeding. So the doctors are already going to investigate them. And these girls will usually, you know, at the age of 5 years, 8 years, 10 years, 9 years, 6 years, whatever, you will know that there is going to be a clotting factor disorder. due to which you are going to be mentally ready to treat a clotting factor disorder as far as menorrhagia or puberty is concerned. And the treatment of choice, the treatment of choice is to give oral contraceptive pills in these girls. It is the treatment of choice. You can give oral contraceptive pills and they are going to be very, very happy.
So there is some protocol or duration that a particular which duration we should follow this protocol, OC pills protocols in such puberty patients.
So normally what practically, for very practical purposes, I'll tell you how we divide it. Okay. We like to give it for 9 cycles. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then wait for 3 cycles. Okay. Then again, give for 9 cycles and again, wait for 3 cycles. But let's assume somebody is having heavy bleeding even in those 3 cycles. Okay.
Okay.
Then the treatment of choice, even in young girls, is to put a Mirena. Okay. It is beautiful. Okay. It works beautifully well in patients with von Willebrand factor disease. It works beautifully well in patients with, Glanzmann thrombocythemias, especially those platelet problems. It works beautifully well.
Okay. Because
one of my patient is hypoplastic uterus and having menses too. So, kya wo puberty ya fertility ke liye ja sakte hain kya?
Hypoplastic uterus ko kabhi bhi tum normoplastic uterus nahi bana sakte. So that means you must.
Menses aata hai sir.
So usko menses aata hoga ek hi din ke liye ya shedding hota hoga sir. Aur agar usko regular menses aata hai, maan ke chaliye, to वो हाइपोप्लास्टिक यूट्रस नहीं है. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. अ हाइपोप्लास्टिक यूट्रस कैन नॉट हैव प्रॉपर मेंसेस एंड इफ इट इज प्रॉपर मेंसेस देन योर अल्ट्रासाउंड डायग्नोसिस इज इनकरेक्ट. इट कैन नॉट बी अ हाइपोप्लास्टिक यूट्रस.
पेशेंट के हिसाब से उसका ये है कि स्कैंटी मेंसेस है बट ऑन यूएसजी रिपोर्ट्स इट्स अ हाइपोप्लास्टिक यूट्रस एंड शी वांट टू कंसीव नाउ. तो
सो दैट मींस शी इज हैविंग स्कैंटी मेंसेस राइट. सो नाउ व्हेन शी हैज स्कैंटी मेंसेस एंड द यूट्रस इज हाइपोप्लास्टिक इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ द यूट्रस. If the size of the uterus is between 4.7 centimeters length and 5.5 centimeters, these ladies can become pregnant with IVF. There is no problem. If the length is less than 4.7 centimeters, there is a very high risk of having abortions in these women. So they should ideally choose for surrogacy because that is the best option. Okay. The best option for these girls.
Jai. One of our participants are regularly take questions. That's what type of OCP pills are best.
So if you want me to define what is the best OCP, okay, so let me tell you that the best OCP doesn't exist. Okay. You should choose the oral contraceptive pill based on patient symptomatology. There are people who like to, these young girls, they have hirsutism. So when you want to treat hirsutism, you need to give an oral contraceptive pill which has an anti-androgen. But let's assume somebody is having heavy bleeding. Then you need to give oral contraceptive pills which are going to have a strong progesterone. For example, levonorgestrel. Okay. Yeah. So that is how you are supposed to decide. Don't go by best OCPs. I know this thing for sure because Bombay mein kaisa karte hai na? Bombay mein family physicians ko koi MR aake bata ke jata hai ki madam aap ye wala tablet hai na, ye bahut acha tablet hai. Ye hi aap likhna. Loate. To sab mein Loate hota hai. Baad mein Dian 35. To sab mein Dian 35 hota hai. Understanding? That is not how you are supposed to do it. If you do it that way, then you are not going to get those results, you know. It will work like a matka. 50 log mein kaam kiya, 50 mein nahi kiya. Something like that.
Jay, can you talk about some ovarian factors that cause pubertal menorrhagia or ovarian tumors? Which specifically cause?
Those are very rare, but still, if you want me to answer that, the answer is very simple. There is only one tumor which family physicians should be aware of, and that is something called as granulosa cell tumor. Okay, there is a variant of that called as juvenile granulosa cell tumor. The incidence is less than one patient in 2.5 lakhs. So there will be many, many, many family physicians who will finish their entire career without seeing a single patient of granulosa cell tumor. But if at all there is a tumor, it is most probably a palpable tumor. Palpable tumor means you can put your hand on the abdomen and feel that there is a tumor. And these patients straight need to go to a gynecologist. There is no role of a family physician managing these patients. Absolutely no role.
Okay. And if we see in Sono, if there is some endometrium has thickened quite
So in such patients, what kind of progesterone we should prefer?
So when the girl is very young, that is the commonest mistake which family physicians do. I think family physicians the commonest, or I think they love the most, jisko apan bolte hai, that is meprate. Unko bahut pasand hai meprate. Koi bhi family physician ko pucho kaun sa progesterone dega, wo bolega meprate. Barabar. But remember, when you have a bleeding, you don't need meprate. Meprate is a very weak progesterone. You need to give a progesterone jisme taakat hai, like an androgenic progesterone, and the drug of choice is to give regesterone. So regesterone is commonly available as Primolutin and all these things, you know. And you know, now the misuse, because one time you have given Primolutin to that patient, next time she has heavy bleeding, she will not come to you. She will take Primolutin on her own. Mother will only give her. The last time Dr. Priyanka ne 3 tablet lene ko bola tha, to chup chap 3 tablet le varna jhapad khayegi. Samajh mein aaya? And that is the misuse. So what we should do, or what I like to do, is that I like to keep on changing every time they come. So they are thoroughly confused. Ke yaar, last time ye diya tha, is time ye diya. And those are all different brands. So one time you should give regesterone, no? Second time you give duphaston. Third time you give meprate. Fourth time when they come, you give, let's say, you give Vizar. So that is Dinogest. That is completely different. Fifth time when they come, you should give Dronis. By the time they come on the sixth time, they've forgotten what you gave them on the first time. Understood?
Yeah.
That will really help. Because the misuse is, a lot of times, these girls take these tablets for postponing periods also. Unke man ke hisab se. Arre, mujhe Goa jana hai sab friends ke saath mein. Madam ne bola tha, ye dawai le lo. To le lo. Khatam. They will not even ask you. You know, and that is a huge misuse, because the commonest problem of these medications is thrombosis. Look, when somebody takes it incorrectly, you are going to cause thrombosis to her, right? And that is why these medications, we are trying very hard to see to it that these medications do not become OTCs. That means over the counters, and you need a prescription for that, right? So I don't know how it works in the future, but then this is how it is supposed to be.
Okay. If we found some patients with the lean PCOS with the primary amenorrhea, how should we start a hormonal regimen in such patients?
It should be started the day you see them. Okay. The day you see them, you should start it. You should not wait for anything. Because look, whenever there is thin PCOS, androgen level is up. So when androgen is up, endometrium is very small, thin endometrium. In a thin endometrium, you should not wait. You should just give OCPs, and you should give OCPs only with a very good concentration of estrogen and an anti-androgen, and it is going to be really helpful to these patients.
Thank you so much, Jaya. Wonderful session.
Sir, maximum so OPDs ke patients hote hain, usme 80% patients ko aaj ki date mein PCOD detect hota hai. तो हर केस में पीसीओडी के सारे केसेस में हमें मेडिसिंस की नीड है क्या?
नहीं, पीसीओएस के 80% ऑफ द पेशेंट्स यू शुड ट्रीट विद वेट लॉस, राइट? 80% ऑफ द पेशेंट्स आर गोइंग टू बी गुड, एस्पेशियली ओबीस पेशेंट्स विद डाइट एंड एक्सरसाइज. ओके, दे आर गोइंग टू बी वेरी गुड ऑन दैट. रिमेंबर पीसीओएस, नो, पीसीओएस इज वन कंडीशन वेर एवरीथिंग वर्क्स. सी, योगा वर्क्स, Ayurvedic works, allopathic works, homeopathic works, acupuncture works, acupressure works, and Baba Ramdev will work, Patanjali will work, everything will work. Pata hai kyun? Because it is a multifactorial problem. It is a multifactorial.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is a multifactorial problem. So everything is good in PCOS. It's just that you should be good at diagnosing what you need to give at what time. What happens with many people is that, see, this is not my first lecture with Neema. Okay, I've given multiple lectures. So what practically happens is, thoda sa, bura mat manna, par thoda sa kabhi kabhi logo ko aisa lag jata hai, are, we should give only Ayurvedic medicine. Don't do that. Do what is good, no?
Yes.
Do I ever come and tell people that I am an allopathic doctor, so I'll not give Ayurvedic medication? No, I'll give. As long as my patient is happy, as long as it is giving effect, you should give. But agar tum aise कठोर बन जाएगा कि नहीं, आयुर्वेदिक को छोड़ के और कुछ भी नहीं, जाओ इधर से, that doesn't really help in PCOS, because you have to respect the fact that everything will work in PCOS. Remember that everything will work.
Okay, Jay, so how to counsel their parents in such cases? This is a common thing that we need to understand when they come with their mother
in PCOS. You mean Priyanka, PCOS you mean? You're talking of counseling in
no,
PCOS?
No, no, general in puberty.
Yeah. See, yeah, no, as I no, said, as I, okay, as I said, even in my lecture, the most common counseling is needed to the mother in puberty yeah. menorrhagia and not to the patient, right?
Yes, yes,
the
that's mother, what I
mean. Yeah, the mother will always compare. You know, she will always compare ke nahi, par wo bola tha to wo udhar ho gaya, ye bola tha to ye udhar ho gaya. Because for a normal lady, there is a strict understanding that 28, 30 days, 32 days, whatever is the regular cycle, so everybody on earth has regular cycles, right? That is their problem. If they think that uske neighbor ko do pad hi use ho raha hai din ka, to meri beti ko char pad kaise use ho sakta hai, you know? Now that is the thing which takes a lot of time to make them understand this. Usually, what typically happens at our level is when somebody is referred to us with puberty menorrhagia, these patients have already been treated before. And when yeah. it is that treatment has failed, that's when they are referred to us, at least to me at least. So by the time they come to me, they are already sure, they have already understood everything. Ki abhi iske samne jaake mujhe awaaz nahi karna hai. You know, wo jo bolega na, wo mujhe chup-chap follow kar raha hai. But one thing I'll tell you, one thing which is very good. In all these mothers whose kids have puberty menorrhagia, right? You must make them speak to somebody else's mother who also has a puberty menorrhagia, whom you have treated, and that patient is good. Because main bolunga na, to usko lagega ki doctor ka to kaam hi hai baat karna. बट अगर कोई दूसरे की माँ जाके उसको बोलेगी ना कि ये जो दवाई दे रहा है ये बराबर है, टाइम लगता है, ऑटोमेटिकली काउंसलिंग इज डन. यू नो दैट मदर विल नॉट डिस्टर्ब यू फॉर सिक्स मंथ्स. वो कुछ नहीं बोलेगी, उसको पता है कि नहीं छह महीना लगने वाला है. सो आई वी हैव दिस गुड सिस्टम वेयर व्हेन वी ट्रीट एडोलेसेंट विमेन, वी नॉर्मली मेक देम स्पीक टू अदर एडोलेसेंट विमेन हु हैव हैड सिमिलर प्रॉब्लम्स, यू नो, एज अ सपोर्ट सर्कल. And that really sorts out the counseling, is what I think everyone should follow, especially family physicians, because family physicians have a lot of patients from one area. So they can really have something like this and it will really help in counseling.
Okay. Does that, you know, pulmonary tuberculosis impact on these diseases?
It can cause a thin endometrium and it can cause permanent amenorrhea. If the pulmonary TB has spread to endometrium, it can cause endometrial fibrosis, which can cause permanent amenorrhea, you know, permanent secondary amenorrhea to women. And it is very common. We see it in our country yeah. very frequently. It needs surgery yeah. then, and you need to do hysteroscopic adhesiolysis for them to get back into periods.
Okay. We need to do the sampling of endometrium in such case also.
It will be fibrosed. You will not get anything.
Okay. Okay. Thank you so much, Jay. Thank you for this wonderful session. Now I request our chairperson, Dr. Vishnu Bhavane sir, to have some, you know, remarks or reviews on this topic. I welcome Dr. Vishnu Bhavane sir.
I have asked Vishnu Bhai to start his video actually. I yeah. can't see him though. Dr. Vishnu, can you start your video? I know him very well. You know, I've met him a few times. He's one of the most amazing guys, you know.
Yeah. One of the versatile gynecologists, you can say, you know. He's involved in various...
Yeah, he's amazing.
Namaste, namaste, sir.
Hello, sir.
Oh, namaste, Hi. Vishnu ji. Kaise
namaste, 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 yes, sir. Yes, sir, fine.
Hi.
Yeah.
Boliye, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Priyanka. Today's program chairman, Dr. Vinayak Temburnikar, sir. He's a president of NIMA CC. Inaugurator, Dr. U.S. Pandey, yeah. sir, secretary NIMA CC. Dr. Sadhana Kulkarni, ma'am, president, Women's Forum, NIMA CC. Dr. Rinmay Masodkar, ma'am, secretary NIMA Women's Forum, CC. And today's dynamic young speaker, and Dr. Jay Mehta, sir. And all the respected delegates and friends. Today's speaker, it's my privilege and honor to be a chairperson for Dr. Jay Mehta's session. I don't think, rather than he left nothing to say about the puberty and the puberty. He covered almost everything about the puberty. It was a very informative, practical, interactive, brainstorming, knowledgeable, and scientific session. In short, what I can say. And he has mentioned very good thing that do what is good to the patient. Prescribe what is good to the patient. That is actually required. Rather than insisting for something, what is better to the patient, that should be adopted. And it should be, we have to respect the fact. He has explained about the, I will not go into that because he has already explained, it will be the repetition. So I would just, because most of the participant delegates, they are integrated practitioner, family physician. So I would just like to add on the things that along with all those things, advice patient to follow the Rajaswala Paricharya right from the very first menses, is right from the menarche, because following the Rajaswala Paricharya, which is mentioned in our classical text, it will help to control the most of the disorders. So you all are aware what is the Rajaswala Paricharya. Even my one I have published one book also on this topic. Nowadays it is very much required to counsel the patient, to make aware the patient about the Rajaswala Paricharya. Simply to, I will highlight one or two points of the Rajaswala Paricharya. Ask the patient to avoid the heavy diet during the menstruation, physical activities, panchakarma procedures, and sleeping in the daytime. These are the few important things that we should make aware the patient or advise to the patient. And that's it. Thank you very much to the organizers for giving me this opportunity.
Sir, would you like to add some Ayurvedic management so that we can get some knowledge regarding that?
No, we will arrange one separate session for that.
Okay.
I think it's sufficient. Suraj ko diya dikhane jaisa ho jaye. Today's, yes.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Neha?
So what we will do is, we will not anybody who has any doubts, please post them on the WhatsApp groups. That is where we will be answering, because there will be too many doubts and we don't want to answer each and every doubt individually. So you can post the doubts on the WhatsApp groups. Most of the people have my, most of the people must be having my mobile numbers, and that is going to be the safest way in which we'll be able to answer. Just in case anyone needs to have my WhatsApp number, I'm just posting it on the chat box. Okay, that happens to be my personal number. You can put a question there, okay, and you have to give me some time, and as and when I do get free during the day, I'll be happy to respond to whatever knowledge I have. Okay. So with this, what we will do is we'll stop the live streaming onto YouTube.